Digging such as this are the regular rule in the glorious, glorious jungle of Newell. The wind is a whisper, the sky a bright blue, and the animals do what the animals do. Yes, things in Newell are the way things in Newell are. There's nothing unusual, odd, or bizarre. As I was saying, things in Newell are the way things in Newell are. Like Jane Kangaroo, the socialite star.
Oh, what a party I'm planning to throw! Regina the Queen will be honored, and so let everyone here, let everyone know!
But only those who are invited should show.
And those who are not will wish they could go.
Pardon? One question, am I invited?
Oh, by Regina herself!
Oh boy, I'm excited!
So you'll come?
Yes, I will.
Was Thidwick's response?
Good. The Queen always gets what the Queen always wants. If I have anything to say about it.
And you do?
Yeah.
So things in Newell are the way things in Newell are.
Jamie, Jane.
That socialite star. No, nothing unusual, odd, or bizarre.
Something even more rare.
From around here?
No, from way out up there.
And they watched and they stared and they worried and wondered as something inside the thing thrumbled and thundered.
Mother, I'm scared.
Say, Junior, who hid?
Then the thing from out there started flipping
its lid.
And up from within, something came into view. A mysterious figure. It grew.
And it grew.
Was it a what? Was it a
who?
My name's Alvin. How do you do?
It's not so scary.
Not scary one bit.
I'll tell you my story, if you'll permit.
And he's polite,
too.
I come from a planet called Malamaroo. I'm the only member of my one-member crew. Home's a long way from me. And if I were back home, home is where I'd be. Oh, Malamaroo, Malamaroo, where the sky's always pink and the sun's always blue. A beautiful world, you'd love it there too. Oh, Malamaroo, Malamaroo, Malamaroo. Hey, anybody know where there's a party?
Well, actually, I was just planning a big party in honor of Regina.
Oh, let me help you.
Let you help?
Let me throw the party for you.
Why should I do that?
We Malamaroons are the partiest people on any planet. Our parties go on for light years. Oh, let me make the party. I'll do it the Malamaroo way. Please, 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 please.
Alvin likes throwing parties so much, let's let him throw ours with an out-of-space touch. It'll make us the stars of the socialite scene.
And score royal points with Regina the Queen.
I can see that you see what I'm meaning to mean, Alvin. If it will make you happy, you may throw my party.
Great! Oh, just leave it to me. I'll make punch, I'll make mix, the Malamaroo way. Just be there by six. I'm making a party. A party I'm making. The partiest party. The cakey is caking. Oh, what a party this party will be. Hey, you want to play a game?
A game? I mean now?
Yes.
Ooh,
don't you have to finish preparing for Mother's party?
I know a jumping game. It's a blasteroo.
No, I don't think so. I mean, Mom would not be happy.
Put this on.
So Alvin from Malamaroo took a break from hanging the banners and icing the cake. And he taught young Junior his jumping up game.
Now this is part one. Bounce higher. Take aim for the tree's highest branch.
Whoa! I caught on. Alvin! Hey, Alvin!
But Alvin was gone. Alvin left Junior out on a limb.
And not to be nasty.
Not Alvin. Not him. Then he ran into Thidwick on East Moose Moss Road.
and offered to help the moose lighten his load.
Well, thanks, Alvin. I've been harvesting moose moss for most of the day. I carry each bundle far, far away.
Then you return?
For stack after stack, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, forth and back.
You store your moss so far from here?
It's a good thing I do this just once a year.
Thidwick, we Malamaroons are great at stacking stuff.
Do tell.
I can help you get this done in one trip. Oh, please let me help. I love to help. Oh, please, 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 please.
Well, help away, friendly visitor from another planet.
Great. I have a two-part plan.
A two-part plan?
Part one, I stack the moose moss on your mighty head.
So Alvin from Malamaroo started stacking, and he didn't stop. No snoozing or snacking. Yes, on Thidwick's
antlers,
he stacked that moss high. A great mound of moose moss that reached to the
sky.
Oh, Alvin, I can't see very well. Pardon me. Alvin?
Alvin!
What about part two of your plan?
At their home down the way, Jane turned to say,
oh, Regina, my queen, this party will be intergalactic. In fact, it's fantastic. Yes. Oh my, nothing is finished. Pardon me, your highness. No, Queen Regina, please, don't.
Well, I'm here for
the party.
There is no party. Alvin didn't finish setting up. Everything is half done.
Well,
I must say I'm not surprised. He left me halfway through also.
What's going on here? Junior! You come down from there at once!
I can't. Alvin left me halfway through a game, and I don't know how to turn this thing off! Whoa!
Hey there! Am I late for the party?
Party? Party? You ruined my party! Why didn't you finish setting everything up?
Yeah, and why did you leave me covered with moose moss?
I have a little trouble finishing what I start.
Ugh, no kidding.
Big surprise.
That's why I'm here. Halfway home. My fellow Malamaroons can't stand me. I'm an embarrassment. Not to mention a lousy friend and neighbor. I'm never going back.
I feel faint.
You mean you ran away from home?
Actually, I ran away from planet. I'm an outcast, a misfit, a halfway guy.
Poor, sad, lonely creature from
another world.
I'll get used to it here. Let's watch television.
I want him gone.
I have an idea that just might help Alvin.
Film by going home.
To show their new friend how good it feels seeing things through to the end.
And that's how you play swoosh ball. Ready?
Ready.
All right then. Pull!
Well, that was fun. Ouch.
The game's not finished yet. You have to keep hitting the ball.
Oh, I do? Mm-hmm. Well,
all right, ready, pull!
Game, Alvin! What happened?
You won.
I did? What an odd sensation.
And they all live happily ever after.
The end.
That's beautiful. Wow, I didn't know anyone in books ever lived happily ever after.
Well, that's because that usually happens at the end of the book.
Ah, you have to finish the book.
Finish.
Yeah. I like finishing feeling.
I thought for sure we'd have gotten through to Alvin.
Maybe he's wandered off somewhere to drive someone else crazy.
Hello.
Goodbye.
My friends, my companions, I've come here to say, you've shown me the light. You've taught me the way to finish the things that I have begun. There are games to be played and races to run.
And books to read.
And journeys back home.
So much to complete.
And journeys back home.
And I've decided to do just that. To go back to Malamaroo to face my friends and finish up everything I left half done.
You're going home. Well, it was so nice having you. Toodaloo, ta-ta, goodbye forever.
But I can't.
What?
What?
I'm out of fuel. I left Malamaroo with only half a tank.
Anything I can do?
Well, I need to find some substance that has tremendous energy. Something we can make fuel out of.
Tremendous energy.
Moose moss? Moose moss is what makes me so mighty. That and plenty of rest, a balanced diet, and clean living.
It could work, but we need plenty of the stuff.
And I know where to get it.
Come along.
Alvin assembled a mushy machine. A moose mossy crushing and crunching machine. It squeezed and it squashed and it squizzled the moss into a pulp, then into a sauce. Then it boiled the sauce. For miles you could smell it. It boiled and boiled it down to a pellet.
We only need 9,846 more pellets to fill the tank.
But we've been stirring for hours.
Even I'm getting
tired.
Come on, gang. Let's not leave this job halfway done.
So they stirred and they stirred, a week and a day, or Alvin would have it no other way. Then, they finally found themselves done. Much, much more done than when they'd begun.
It was nice meeting you.
Come back soon,
with a round trip ticket.
You, my new friends, have taught me so much. It makes me want to
sing.
You did that already.
But I didn't finish. Hit it! Such a beautiful world, you'd love it now too. Ooh, Malamaroo.
Alvin yelled,
"Stop!"
And then Alvin said,
"Once more from the top!"